DNA breaks, are they a nucleator of the PARP assembly, not just the dimer, but all the other PARPs? And therefore, the PARP on the DNA, and you said there was quite a bit, that's not near a double-stranded break, in principle, would make a condensate with DNA, but it would take a long time, and the breaks are what nucleate this. Or is the break in an intrinsic part of the condensate, the bridging of the break, an intrinsic part of the condensate, and the break region is not really so much smaller than the condensate itself? I don't hear an answer. Do you hear me? Hello? It sounds to me like the, yes, like the break is the nucleator of the of all the parts. Okay. That was exactly my question. So in principle, you have enough PARP on DNA. If you would have PARP DNA, yeah, recruits the rest. Yes. Yes. So that means if you had a region with unbroken double-stranded DNA and a relatively high concentration of PARP, they might, given enough time, make a condensate as well. But the break is really nucleating it to happen much more quickly in that region. Okay. Very good. Okay. I think it's a nucleator. Thank you.